Aujourd'hui, Chloé Charles va monter sur le ring pour affronter le public en musique, bien sûr. Avant le moment décisif, je l'accueille dans les vestiaires. Un moment d'intimité pour mieux connaître son histoire et ses rêves. Dans un même temps, je vais la coacher, la chauffer à blanc, jusqu'à sa montée sur scène, sous le pinceau de Joël Jolivet qui va dessiner son univers. La gracieuse Chloé Charles rentre dans l'arène musicale. Chloé Charles, c'est la bonne surprise de ce début d'année 2014. Jeune et jolie métisse, elle plante ses origines au Canada, à Toronto, où elle a grandi en écoutant les standards du jazz et de la soul des années 60. Mais son parcours musical se situe plutôt à mi-chemin entre la pop et la folk. Elle a appris toute seule à jouer de la guitare il y a tout juste quelques années, de quoi lui permettre de produire un premier excellent album intitulé Break the Balance, qui est une histoire à la fois de dualité et d'équilibre. Chloé Charles est là pour la première fois avec nous dans l'arène musicale, mais en Allemagne, aux Pays-Bas ou encore en Suisse, ils sont déjà séduits par sa voix de velours. Chloé Charles est dans le ring. Bienvenue dans l'arène musicale. Hello, Chloé.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm wonderful. Thank
you. Let me introduce you to our painter, Joël Jolivet.
Enchantée.
Elle est en train de peindre les affiches de ton ring. Tu les découvriras sur scène ce soir. Et vous allez évidemment retrouver toutes les missions et les peintures de Joël Jolivet sur notre Facebook Le Ring. Let's start by the cube, actually. This is a box where all your influences are inside. So let's start by the picture that you want.
Here we've got Joni Mitchell. I was introduced to her by my mom, and she was in love with the album Blue.
Yeah.
And I fell in love with that album as well because it's sort of melancholy and really beautiful at the same time and very delicate. And the way she writes songs, there's really no specific structure that she sticks to. She's very free and her voice is incredible and her lyrics are so poetic. So I think as a child I listened to her and that somewhere snuck into the way I write and sort of the freedom that I think that you can have to write songs.
Another picture?
Here we've got Tolstoy.
Yeah.
I went through a period where I was really obsessed with classics and...
Why? You know why?
Why? Well, it's funny, again, probably a lot to do with my mom. She studied classics and Greek mythology, so we had tons and tons of classics in our house, and I made a decision to go through all of them. And yeah.
You're white or black. It's like you do everything like...
or nothing.
Yeah.
It's pretty much.
Yeah, intense.
Yeah, so I got into Tolstoy, and his writing is just... I love these books that get into sort of the darkest parts of humanity, and obviously he does that very well. And sort of that... that interest in people and in their inner workings, that's always been a part of me. And so when I read these books, I think that sort of that desire to dig into people's emotions just comes up in me, and it really connects with the way I write.
Another influence?
Bjork. My main reason for choosing her is that I really respect the fact that she has really always done what she wants, and it's not even so much just the music that speaks to me, it's just her attitude that, you know, she has something really special to create and, you know, she's going to find her audience, and she did find her audience, and it's, you know, she never tailored her stuff to be, you know, mainstream or radio.
Yeah.
It's art, it really is art, and I think that's beautiful, and it's a representation of that working and becoming successful and having respect for really being true to yourself. And so that is something that I always try to do, and I think that's really hard, but...
Yeah, would you say freedom is very hard to get?
I don't think it's hard to get. I think it's hard to...
assume?
Maintain, sort of.
Yeah.
I mean, because you have to work really hard, and sometimes it's not as easy, but I think in the end it's more rewarding, perhaps.
Yeah.
Another
one?
Frank, Kafka. I love all of his books, but I really love The Trial. And it's just so insane the way it sort of looks at society and how crazy it is. And I really never felt that I myself fit in very well to society. And so when I read this, it made me, I mean, it's kind of sad, but it's really funny as well, just how ridiculous things are and how something...
Situations.
Yeah, they just don't work sometimes.
Yeah, yeah.
You're completely spinning in circles around and around and around. And to me, that's just the story of human
life.
Existence.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I think we've done with the cube.
All right.
So now we're going to discover your playlist.
All right.
The playlist you have to survive.
That's fun. That sounds great.
What a program. C'est le moment maintenant de retrouver la playlist de Chloé Charles, la playlist que vous retrouverez également sur l'application dédiée Deezer Le Ring. Chloé, what is the title you want to start by?
Right here, I have Dragonfly by My Brightest Diamond.
Yeah.
And I discovered this song through my guitarist in Toronto, and I love it because it's like magical. It's very magical, and the instrumentation is incredible. She uses, you know, a lot of classical influences and mixed with something very modern, and the way she represents herself is very just beautiful.
Would you say that you learn guitar through this kind of music?
No, but I think it opens my mind to the possibilities in terms of how you can create an atmosphere around a song and, you know, the endless possibilities for production. I mean, she really goes all out with her stuff.
Okay, another one.
This one is from my childhood.
Yeah, the Fugees.
The Fugees. I love the Fugees, and I love Ready or Not, and I think this is one of the songs that I sang over and over and over. I mean, it's only a little part that Lauryn Hill is singing, but I loved that line, and it got stuck in my head, and I think I wanted to sort of be her when I was younger. And this one is very recent. It's DJ called XXYYXX, and...
A lot of X.
Yeah, there's this one track called About You, and we listened to it on tour in the car pretty much like 10 times a day.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think so. I don't know how.
And at the end of the day, you still love it?
I still love this song. It still puts me in a really good mood. It's very, very mellow, and the bass is just so cool. It's like in slow motion, everything, but I recommend it. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Chloé.
Pleasure. Si vous deviez faire un groupe avec deux artistes connus, avec qui partagerez-vous votre musique? I think that I would really love to work with James Blake. And if I could pick someone from the past, Etta James.
Est-ce que vous avez déjà fait de la musique avec Julian Lennon?
No, not yet. Maybe one day.
Allez-vous ajouter des dates de concert en France cette année?
Oui. March 24th at Casino Nouveau.